Well, just a week after the story of Shirley Sherrod, we have a new story tonight involving race and gender. The controversy this time involves the leading fashion and lifestyle magazine for African-American women, Essence, which is, we should point out, a Time publication, which is a corporate cousin to CNN. Now, Essence has hired a white woman as its new fashion director. Now, you might think, okay, so what? But it's prompted an uproar online started by an African-American woman who used to hold that position at Essence. And essentially, she's arguing that there are so few opportunities for African-American women in fashion that for Essence to not hire an African-American is inappropriate. Her critics, however, say that attacking a black magazine for hiring a white woman is essentially reverse racism. The woman who used to hold that job at Essence joins us, cultural critic Michaela Angela Davis. Thanks for being with us. And also with us is CNN analyst Roland Martin. Now, Michaela, you wouldn't argue that a white fashion magazine should hire a white fashion director. So why is it okay to argue that a black fashion magazine should hire a black director?
Well, you know, Anderson, I don't know of any women's magazine that says they're a white fashion magazine. Vogue does not say that. They say that they are there for luxury and elitism or a class. Essence is the one magazine in that kiosk that puts race in their brand. They say, this is the place for African American women, the place where black women come first. So black is in their brand DNA. No, Marie Claire, oh, glamour, we can go on and on and on.
That's
they
marketing.
Don't say that.
That's marketing though. I mean,
but it's a promise to a reader. It's a promise to an audience. So no other magazine, Vogue doesn't say they're white. They're not a white magazine. However, all those titles that I have said, there's not one fashion director
that is
black.
But would it be okay for,
there.
Say, I don't know what the stats for Town and Country magazine, but
right.
That used to be a magazine geared toward like New York society, which is
right.
Probably overwhelmingly white. Would it be okay for Town and Country to say, well, since most of our readers are white, mm-hmm. we've done surveys and they're white, we only want a white director? You would say that's outrageous.
Well, no, I wouldn't. Because I haven't said that. What you have said, that's something that's implied. This is saying, when you say that you are the one magazine that is there to reflect and celebrate the African-American woman through
right.
the very specific filter of the African-American woman experience, you put race in, it's not, you put race in your brand, you don't,
I got it.
It's not inherent. Do you know what I mean?
I mean, I understand frustration, Roland. There are not more African American women or possibilities for more African women to get positions
right.
of power in magazines. But is non-colorblind hiring the answer?
Well, I think, first of all, there's a history. If you look at black publications historically, I worked at Savoy Magazine when McKay was at Honey Magazine. There were white staffers there. I've run black newspapers. I've had white staffers there as well. There have been folks who are white who edited black newspapers. You look at Mr. Greenberg, who was the second person to lead the NAACP Legal Defense and Education Fund after Thurgood Marshall. As an advocate of diversity, I can't say you don't hire the best person. And so if that is a slippery slope that we walk on, I understand Michaela's point, but I do believe the larger point is that you have a massive lack of opportunities across the magazine industry. I remember, 1992 when Spike Lee said he only wanted black folks to come interview him. What happened was he was saying, you need to go hire some people. Magazines looked up and said, whoa, where are the black people? And they realize, wow, we don't have any. And so his stance changed the industry. You have to have more of that, but I just can't say I want to deny a white person an opportunity when I don't want to see an African-American denied an opportunity at any other magazine. They should be held accountable to have diverse staffs, and unfortunately, they do not.
To that point, and Spike Lee's a very good example, that he ushered in a lot of people who would not be in the film industry, would not get credentials had it not been for him. Essence
True.
Was that gateway. I became an editor at Essence. So then I went on to contribute to Vanity Fair. I've had a very rich career where I have hired people of all colors. But
I'm told when you were at Honey Magazine, you hired a white person to be an art director.
Yes, and Honey is an urban magazine. It does not say black. It reflects urban aesthetics and urban and hip-hop aesthetics. It did not say the place for young black women. I was very close to hiring a Latino fashion editor because she worked at Sex and the City and The Source, which reflected urban culture. So this is about reflecting the culture in which you say you stand. And quite honestly, Anderson,
we see this debate
Go ahead, Roland.
We do see this debate with Hispanic publications as well. We see the same debate when it comes to gender. If you have a magazine that is targeting women, then all of a sudden, if you have a man who is in charge of that. So we've seen these debates. But again, I understand Michaela's point in terms of Essence brand targeting black women. But here's what this says to me. What it also says is that Essence is frankly more progressive as a black women's magazine than all of these other magazines out there who refuse to hire African-American and Hispanics. I think what the argument should be, and as a member of the board of directors of the National Association of Black Journalists, we are targeting the magazine industry, these online publications, cable networks, broadcast networks, who continue to deny opportunities for people, and we're saying the America is changing, so how can't you hire anybody? And I do believe that if there are more African-Americans and Hispanics at those fashion magazines, Michaela's argument also might be a little bit different because the opportunities are more plentiful. What she's really saying is this is the only shot you really have because the rest of the folks are not hiring you.
But I'm saying this also for literally the black girls that called me crying, that had, this is the one place, you know, you come from the fashion elite, you know, from a family that knows it. There's one seat in the shows that is for black people. Just one seat at the table that where you can usher in other people, where you can gain not just self-esteem and self-love, but professional experience. So this is also sending a message to those girls. Are you not qualified? There are plenty of qualified black female fashion professionals. What does this say to them? What does this say to the industry at large? If the one place doesn't feel that you can determine your own look, your own style.
Yeah, that is, we need to target the industry. You cannot have the number of magazines out there. Roy Johnson cannot be the only African-American editing a non-black magazine. That makes no sense in 2010. That's the real issue. We should be fighting those folks to say, open the doors now.
Got to leave it there.
The one open doors now closed, it feels that way.
Roland Martin as well. I want our viewers to weigh in on this at the blog, ac360.com. The live chat is up and running. Let us know what you think. Interesting discussion. We reached out to Essence Magazine to come on the program tonight. They declined. The magazine's editor-in-chief gave us this statement. Our new fashion director, Eliana Placas, is part of a growing fashion team at Essence. We are making a number of new hires in the coming months. I understand that this issue has struck an emotional chord with our audience. However, I've selected Eliana, who has been contributing to the magazine on a freelance basis for the last 6 months because of her creativity, vision, the positive reader response to her work, and her enthusiasm and respect for the audience and our brand. We remain committed to celebrating the unique beauty and style of African-American women in Essence Magazine and online at Essence.com.